In order to be one with the audio channel, you must be a master Podjockey. There is no other way. You must eat, breathe, sleep Podjockey. Subscribe.
Welcome, everybody, to another episode of Podjockey. I'm your host, Master Impressive.
And I'm Director Awesome.
Today, in part three of the coronavirus COVID-19 series, we're going to be looking at another conspiracy theory plus an end time prophecy and how that equals the Chinese government power grab happening right now. So we have our world, the box we live in, and all the human puzzle pieces. But we can't see the final picture that all these puzzle pieces make. Why? Because you can only see the final picture if you're looking at this from the outside. If you're just joining our podcast, welcome. Before we get into this, for those of you who haven't checked out part one and two of this series, we strongly suggest that you do, as they lay the groundwork for what you're about to hear. In part one, we looked at rap name generator results for the COVID-19 and coronavirus names. Boy, did we ever get some ominous, crazy, weird, and interesting results that relate to the spiritual aspect of what's going on in the world. Now, Director Awesome, we stated to our listeners back in episode one that we should do a follow-up episode on the COVID-19 crisis from this spiritual point of view, and that was all due to the fact that one specific rap name generated result warranted a follow-up episode, and we just couldn't help ourselves. So when we were talking about this in the first episode, at that point, you knew we were already going to do this, right?
Right. I mean, we did look at some of the names that came out of the generator. And like you said, some of them came out really scary, I guess, and kind of hit the nail on the head. And we were wondering, I guess, what that actually meant. We actually did like a shout out to our emergency personnel workers, read some comments about YouTube, and then threw it out there if we should do the spiritual aspect of this whole thing. So I think that's what we're going to get into now.
Yeah, I think when we were talking about that, we knew already at that point there that we were going to do it. We just had to push ourselves, but it didn't take much to actually get us going. We did our research and we're looking at things in the background and checking stuff out on the net, listening to YouTube videos, checking out articles, and here we are. So here's the premise. Is this COVID-19 coronavirus disaster just another simple virus? Nothing to see here, move along. Is it an inept attempt by the Chinese Communist government to cover up mismanaged testing and storage of a dangerous pathogen? Or is this a more sinister secret governmental plan to use a biological weapon meant to incapacitate a good portion of humanity and destroy the world's economies and democracies? After all, the Chinese Communist Party would never let a good opportunity go to waste. And finally, are the tyrannical communist dictators in China acting of their own malicious accord, or do they serve as human agents of evil itself? The devil being bold. And that, by the way, was a tie-in to the first episode. See, we told you to go listen to part one and two first.
The COVID-19 rap name generator result that blew our minds had us questioning our outlook on things, right?
Yeah,
and
that's right.
One of the results that came up was, like you just mentioned, devil bold. And it seems like the algorithm and AI were speaking the truth from the net. We were looking at digital prophecy in the making. Perhaps a sentient AI is running about on the net. Remember, Google, don't be evil.
That's right, especially since that's their motto, don't be evil.
So I'm kind of going to read a segment from our first episode that will help listeners that might be joining us for the first time better understand our viewpoint on questioning everything, especially now. And it reads, as mentioned in part one of this three-part series, I don't think this result is just a one-off, a fluke, a just-by-chance coincidence. I've experienced many unexplainable events in my life, and I've come to realize that there are no coincidences. Regarding the COVID-19 coronavirus episode that we're currently viewing on a global scale, I'm skeptical of whatever the mass hysteria media engine is feeding us Like many people, I don't take as gospel the narrative that's being presented to us by the media, and I'm very wary of those in power who control and govern what we see and hear from our media information outlets. My questioning of the powers that be in no way dismisses or diminishes the tragic effect that the virus has had on so many lives. I'm fully aware that the cost has been very, very high. However, please keep an open mind and consider some of the following points. I'm talking about humanity's leaders, the power brokers, and their minions behind the scenes that are running the show, and their trustworthiness, especially when those in power are doing and saying things which contradict a rational and logical response to what seems to be yet another strain of virus that humanity has seen time and time again and will come and go just like all the other maladies that our race has seen throughout the ages. There are a lot of nasty players on the world stage who would like nothing more than to be in full control of this ride. So the question is, will you take a stand and question those in power, or just get in line and have them make up your mind for you and have them tell you what to do, think, and say? Just something to think about. And now we will go into how the Devil Bold rap name result that we mentioned earlier ties into the end times prophecy and the role of the Chinese Communist Party in setting humanity's last act.
In this episode, we present a look at how things might be playing out. So listen and decide for yourselves. The prophecy states in brief that a worldwide apostasy, a great revolt of Christians away from the true faith, precedes the coming of the Antichrist. This rejection of God and faith and the termination of public worship at Mass for many Christians today is a portent of bad things to come. Once the apostasy is complete, then the power of the Roman Empire, which is to say, the power of the remaining democracies in the West, will be terminated. And the U.S. is the last democratic bastion left that can mount any sort of defense against attacks from its enemies, Russia, China, and the Middle East dictatorships that support them. Now, back to the first point, Christians abandoning their faith. This has already happened. It's a fact. Many have gone their own way. Public worship has also been banned as well. This is a fact. And now this brings us to the capitulation from West to East. Was the virus from China just an accident or a deliberate attempt to strong-arm the U.S. and its remaining allies to become subjugated to Chinese economic and military rule? I put nothing past these evil actors in the Chinese Communist Party.
When we're talking about religion here, when we look at the Bible, what we're looking at is Revelation 13:15, which predicts a beast will prevent Christians from carrying out worship. Now, what are we talking about in this beast? Are we talking about an actual mythological creature? Or are we talking about this virus? Or are we talking about those in power? This is where you have to make up your own mind when we're talking about the beast, right? You're trying to think of what this beast is and why it's preventing Christians from carrying out worship. Now, when we're talking about the Antichrist, what are we talking about here? Is this just an individual, or is the Antichrist actually an institution?
To explore that last point there, in the prophecies that St. Robert Bellarmine, who is the author of this prophecy, he actually states that the Antichrist is an actual individual, a man, who is perfectly possessed by the devil.
Let's take a look at the other side of saying, is it an institution? Is it a group of people who are being run by the devil as well, saying like a government establishment or just more than one person? I know with Robert Bellarmine, him calling him the false prophet, and it was just the one individual, but there are theories out there that it is, you know, kind of an establishment and not just an individual. There are some interesting predictions that I looked up, and they're actually pretty interesting on the religious side of it. What it says is America started in Jamestown, Virginia, settlement named after King James. Mm-hmm. He became king over much of the world in the year 1603 CE. If one goes to Matthew 1603, one sees a reference to discerning the signs of the times. A five-pointed star, the symbol of Satanism, fits neatly into the design of the Pentagon, America's military headquarters. The central space defined by a pentagram forms the shape of the Pentagon. The cross is in the shape of the letter T, which is the 20th character in the alphabet, a configuration of two cross symbols worn on opposite lapels by some clergy, therefore can be interpreted as the number 2020. John 20:20 refers to disciples seeing the Lord, and the pilgrims landed in 1620 CE, exactly 400 years from 2020. The Bible refers to an unfulfilled 400-year prophecy.
That's Those very are pretty interesting. Yes. That's some good background research there, Director Awesome. Yeah, I didn't know about that.
So, I mean, there are a lot of tie-ins to the Bible, any kind of scripture. They talk about the seals being opened right now and that we're on the seventh seal that's being opened at this point in time right now. So there are a lot of things that are out there talking about the tie-ins with religion and end times. And could this be our final push towards end times? So this is something that you have to take and educate yourself on, come up with your own conclusions for this. This is stuff that we've just done some research on and that we're just putting out there for you. So,
and everyone has to remember that prophecy is basically fulfilled in its completion. And again, we're just presenting this. We don't know if this is true or not. You don't have to believe this, but we found this very interesting. And it just seems like right now there's this push from the Chinese and maybe some of the actors in the background who have the power and the money to strong arm, to wrestle away the power of the United States and the democracies and put it into the hands of those who want the power, who want the control. And that would be the Chinese and all their allies. They would love nothing more than to put America into its place and everybody else. And they've pretty much already done that, but they just need that extra little push. And it seems like this virus has been very, very convenient. And that's, I guess that's what we wanted to put out there and just have you all look at it from that point of view. Now, if I can go back to the first point here about Christians abandoning their faith, this has already happened. It's a fact. And many have gone their own way. Public worship has also been banned. This is a fact as well. And now this brings us to the capitulation part from the West to the East. Was the virus from China just an accident or a deliberate attempt to strong arm the US and its remaining allies to become subjugated to Chinese economic and military rule? I put nothing past these evil actors in the Chinese Communist Party. They will do whatever they can to bring about their control over the whole world. Just look at the attacks from the Chinese officials and governmental operatives against all the faith groups and minorities in China. And this is especially fierce and directly targeted against Christians. The Red Dragon has infiltrated the world markets and economies. They've made a financial killing and even now are touting their resiliency and adeptness at making money when the rest of the world's economies are in the tank. The Communist Party made money off of selling defective respiratory masks and protective gear to countries who are dealing with a pandemic caused by who? China. The Chinese government steals everything that isn't hammered to the floor: resources, technology, manufacturing, pharma production. And the production of medicines is now completely controlled by China, and they have the world by the throat, basically. I remember watching on the news that there's a big concern now that all the pharma control is in China's hands. So, Dr. Awesome, if they wanted to, they could just stop the production of medicine and stop the flow coming to the West. It's pretty scary to think about that.
I mean, we have to look at it on a whole scale of everything. We want to source out everything to China when it's convenient for us, right? So
sure.
When we say, you know what, we get a cheaper iPhone because it's made over there in China, and now you're looking at them making the product for us and shipping it over here, and they kind of want to control that market as well. And now we're looking at a whole different story now because they can shut it down and then we have no supply whatsoever.
That all comes back to people getting greedy and wanting to make the most amount of money off their sales to us here. And yet in China, the people that are making these products are basically slave labor. Sometimes they don't even get paid. No one cares about their health and safety, their well-being. They're just treated like animals over there.
You know, we even have like the price gouging going on here, and I can understand it even from two different points. So the one side, you look at it, you see, you know, hand sanitizer in my neighborhood for like a small bottle is selling for $10. And wow, that's ludicrous. And then you look at a pack of Lysol wipes was selling at one of the stores in Toronto for $28. Now, they come out and said it was a mistake. And of course they did, because they got caught when they were doing it. But they're doing this whole price gouging thing. Now, I can see individuals selling stuff for a lot more than it's worth because a lot of people have lost their jobs over this or got laid off over this, have no income coming in, and I can see that. But then you're taking advantage of the rest of the world who's trying to protect themselves from this as well.
Yeah, that's right. Actually, the store that you mentioned is very close to where I am. And so it was like $30 that they were charging for a little container of wipes.
Yeah.
$30. It was just crazy. They got called out by our premier. And then all of a sudden, oh no, it's a big mistake. And we didn't know it was a price error. And sure it was, only because you got caught with your pants down.
and how many people actually bought those because they can't find them anywhere? Now, if you go out to the Costco's and stuff like that, they have the signs up outside right now saying, you know what? We have no toilet paper. We have no paper towel. We have no Lysol wipes. Everything is out of stock. Like, you can't even find it. You'll have to see posts online saying, you know, I'm at a Walmart right now and they have a whole aisle of toilet paper available right now. You know, 10 minutes later, somebody goes and says the aisle's empty. So where is all this stuff going?
I know we're getting a little off track. We're going to get back to the main point, but I just wanted to mention that our premier, Mr. Ford, is doing a fantastic job. A lot of people don't like his technique, but what he's doing now for the province of Ontario is amazing. He is basically putting to shame the Prime Minister of Canada. The Premier of Ontario has said, screw it, I'm going to take the reins. I'm going to drive this bus. And he's doing a really good job. So props to Mr. Ford. Keep it up. And a lot of people are noticing this and saying that he's doing a fantastic job. So having said that, I'm just going to continue back with some of the main points here that we were talking about with the corrupt communist regime in China. So they manipulate their currency, they imprison and destroy their own citizens. And by any chance, has anyone seen the documentaries on China's AI surveillance mechanism that they created and incorporated into their own country against their own citizens? That is some crazy stuff. The poor Chinese people at the bottom of the ladder, the same poor working slave class in servitude to the communist regime, they are prisoners in their own country, in their own neighborhoods, in their own houses. And like we were talking about before, corrupt elite money men from the West continue to do business with these red tyrants. Maybe that was also part of the plan all along, to aid and abet the communist regime, to cement its place on the world stage. Yet another puzzle piece to set up the final picture. So, Director Awesome, I think you were going to be talking about some of the actions of late of the Chinese communist government.
Right.
Just a quick summary.
Yeah, so we're talking about them selling faulty masks and protective gear, reaping countless dollars in revenue while the country's buying in good faith or having their frontline workers, doctors, nurses getting infected and dying. The Chinese communist regime is laughing at everybody. You know, world leaders stating that there will be retaliation against China threatening the world. It's become the world's de facto pharma supplier and is threatening economic retaliation against competing economies and initiating a new ground game to accelerate their world market domination, consolidate their power, and wrestle away what little control other markets have, for example, the U.S. China needs to be punished, but they are in this advantageous position, I guess, now due to these very same market forces that were looking at cheaper manufacturing costs and went to China in the first place. Maybe that was part of the overall plan. Remember, the puzzle pieces, each piece is attached to the other piece, making the picture clearer and clearer. What the final picture looks like from the outside is up to anyone's guess. In the end, the final act for humanity, who knows? I don't. Scientific advisors have reportedly told British Prime Minister Boris Johnson that the Chinese communist government has downplayed the true extent of the corona outbreak in their country and that the real number could be 15 to 40 times higher than what China has reported. Mass burials, cremation, and common citizens reported that the world is being fed a full bullshit buffet. The communists are good at propaganda. Now, what their health authorities were actually saying, that they were no longer going to count as confirmed cases the patients who test positive but don't show symptoms. The change in counting cases is only one factor that's made it difficult for experts to determine the true scale of the epidemic. So think about that. If you didn't show symptoms, but you tested positive, those numbers were not being counted.
Correct me if I'm wrong, but I think that they've banned all media and any scientific or health experts to be there on the ground, double checking the stats or looking at the situation. Basically, they're trying to keep everybody out.
And I believe that's what's going on right now, because they're trying to hide the truth of what's actually happening. Like, you're saying that in Wuhan right now, they're getting zero cases whatsoever. Except people that are traveling in. Now, if I'm not mistaken, was travel not banned all over the place? No flights coming in, no ships going in, nothing like that. Where are these travelers coming from that they're going into the country of China and having infections? Like, where are all these people coming from?
That's the main thing. Listening to the media, trying to figure out who's telling the truth, what's propaganda, what are lies, what's fabrication. Who knows? I just know that the Chinese Communist government cannot be trusted. They can't be trusted. They cannot be trusted. Basically, that's what it comes down to. So whatever they say, don't take it with a grain of salt. Take it with a bag of salt, because ultimately they're in it for themselves. And like I was saying before, they're trying to construct this narrative that makes them seem like they have no issues. They have everything under control, and that this mass hysteria that's going on in the West is just some sort of anti-Chinese propaganda from Trump and from the U.S. military and anyone else who has a bone to pick with the Chinese. And that's not true. The communists in China, they just suck, and no one believes anything that they say. And it's funny how a lot of the health professionals in China, the doctors and any of the people that were working at the clinics who reported on the spread of the virus or were giving any updates, they all disappeared, or they've been censored, or they've been fined. Those are the facts. So,
well, one of the whistleblowers that was one of the first, I guess, to come out with this whole thing about the coronavirus ended up dead, right?
So that's true. And he was in his late 30s, correct?
I believe so.
That was very suspicious because he disappeared right away for, I think it was at least 20 days. And then next thing you know, he's dead from the virus. People were, no, that's not why he died. And I totally believe that he didn't die from the virus, that they took him out because he made them look bad. They wanted to save face. With the Chinese government, saving face at all cost, that's what matters. Doesn't matter if people get in the way, you know, just remember Tiananmen Square. That's what they do. That's what they're good at. There's no value for human life, no freedom of religion, no democracy, nothing. You just basically eat what they give you, do what they say. And if not, you disappear, you die, you go to some re-education camp. They have also these new camps where they've enslaved religious minorities or political dissidents or anyone who gets in the way. And it's not just a couple hundred or a couple of thousand. There's a large number of people that are in detention right now. And basically, they're government-run concentration camps. And that's why we shouldn't trust the Chinese Communist government at any level on anything.
So I'm going to take it back to something we talked about in episode 2, one of the conspiracies that was out there about the 5G networks. And this is going to tie into China as well, because in November of 2019, the 5G networks were being turned on in China. So people started to question this and say, was the coronavirus connected to the 5G networks? Was the 5G networks what was causing the coronavirus? But there's another end to this, because the 5G networks were being built, and did they release the coronavirus on purpose? This led to a no exchange of cash. So everything was going to be done electronically. Develop an RFID chip and implant it as a vaccine. They now have control of you. They can monitor wherever you are, know everything about you. This coronavirus, if people are to lose their lives, it's not a big deal to them. This is not the first time that a government will have sacrificed lives to finish their agenda.
Again, I wouldn't put anything past them. What is actually happening right now, who knows? No one knows except them and the people that have direct frontline knowledge of them, maybe some spies from some foreign governments who have some contacts that are keeping their eyes on things. But other than that, who knows? I have no idea. But those are good points. That also ties into the Huawei 5G network and allowing them to build networks in the West. I know that the United States has come out against that, and I think that they banned them from doing anything like that. But here in Canada, I haven't heard anything. They said that they were going to look into this, and I haven't heard a thing. Go ahead.
So the problem here is that I don't know enough about 5G networks. I don't know enough about the technology of this stuff. So I very highly doubt that 5G networks have anything to do with it. Is it going to be able to broadcast a signal into an RFID chip? Hey, you know what? Stranger things have happened. I don't put it past anybody of doing that, but at the same time, I don't have enough knowledge on this stuff right now. I'm just giving you what's out there and what the actual opinions of some people are, and I don't want to get too much into that conspiracy.
Yeah, I guess the main point of the whole Huawei thing is having the Chinese backend basically as a parasite in our network infrastructure. So if you allow the Chinese Communist government to get their hands into your communications infrastructure, you think that they won't use that to their advantage? I mean, come on. If they allow the Chinese into Canada, and they're already here in a very limited capacity, but if they full on give them complete access to our telecommunications, it's over.
Why don't we look at maybe some of the stuff that's coming out of our countries, I guess, Canada and the US and stuff like that, just to kind of turn a different page here from the Chinese for a minute and talk about a different look on what's happening here with the coronavirus. Now, in my research, what I was doing is I found out in 2019, in the past year alone, 1,300 CEOs from McDonald's to Google to Boeing to Nike have all stepped down or been fired in just this past year. Why? Why has this happened? 1,300, that's a big number. And why was this happening? Did they all know that this was coming, that a recession was about to start, and because of it, they all cashed out? Now, WeWork CEO stepped down with a $1.7 billion package. Wow. The last time that this happened, when this amount of CEOs stepped down, was in 2008 when the financial crisis hit. So why are these CEOs all stepping down before some kind of recession is coming?
It's funny that you mentioned that, because I saw a little clip online and they were talking about this very thing. And they were saying, well, you know, they were doing inappropriate things in the background. I think they mentioned something like 40%.
But sure, okay. That's what they want to tell us this.
Sure,
that's absolutely the story they want to tell us.
But even if that was true, that's 40%. What about the other 60%? And so again, like you were saying, a lot of people are watching this and saying, this is crazy and this is concerning, and we're watching this happening. And we're wondering why. What is the reason behind the scenes that's initiating this exodus of these high-ranking CEOs? And that's just another puzzle piece. Do they know something that we don't? Were they given some warning as to what's coming down the road? Were they forced out? I don't know.
Well, see, I lean more towards that they were given a warning that something was coming, because, you know, you don't have that amount of people cash out that amount of money for no reason at all. You know, you have the CEO of Disney who stepped down, and he had a lot to do with the signing of Disney Plus and Marvel and stuff
just
like
started,
that, you know.
Sure. And that went online not too long ago. So it's, you know, just to leave all that stuff hanging in the air just causes a lot of people to question what's going on, right?
So, you know, I understand the McDonald's CEO apparently had an inappropriate relationship with one of the workers, but that's the story we're being told. Do we know that that was actual fact? I haven't done enough research to know what the actual facts of that were, but at the end of the day, this is way too many CEOs just to be stepping away. They just wanted to be out of the company and didn't want to put in the time anymore and just got tired and wanted to retire and taking all these packages. They had to foresee something coming. They had to be warned that something was coming in order for that amount of people to actually step away from it all.
Basically, what you're saying is coincidence? I think not.
Right.
And you know what? Mm. The way things are and what we're seeing, what we're hearing causes us to say, yeah, you know what? Not coincidence. Again, it's all those little puzzle pieces that add up to the big picture, which we can't currently see. Just continuing on with that, I think right now, a lot of our leaders here in the West are showing their true colors.
Yeah.
they basically have to either support their population, support democracy, or they're just coming out, sitting on their hands, not doing anything and saying, yeah, lip service, we're just doing what we can. We have to be compassionate. Never mind about banning flights from China, because in Canada, that's not happening. As far as I know, they're letting everybody in still. From what I understand, people are still coming through the border unless that situation has changed. And yet we're told to self-isolate, do all this other stuff. And meanwhile, they're not taking care of business. And like you were mentioning, Dr. Awesome, in the past episodes there, they didn't do anything right off the bat. And that's why we're in the situation where so many people have died. The spread is, it's still clipping along.
Well, we're looking at the U.S. now is coming out and said they're expecting that 100,000 to 240,000 Americans will lose their lives over this. Think about that number. I mean, I know they have about 360, 370 million people in the States. However, that is a staggering number of lives to lose from this virus alone. And that's just in the U.S. alone that they are predicting that that many people will lose their lives. That's incredible.
It is. Yeah. No, it's crazy to think about that, mind you. And then you also have Spain, Italy. They're just getting completely hammered. People are dropping like flies. It's so bad over there.
And again, the misinformed numbers from China. So we really don't know what the whole global effect is on this right now in terms of numbers. We can just go by what the media is telling us right now. We're not sitting in front of the papers or doing any testing, so we don't actually know the actual numbers.
No, we don't.
I mean, by the end of all this, I mean, you could lose a good chunk of population.
You could. Yeah. And again, this ties back into our premise that we made at the beginning of the episode. Is this natural or was this a constructed event? Now, this leads us to the conclusion here. So are we seeing the end of the U.S. and its allies being taken out not by a direct Chinese frontal attack with a military intrusion, but by a slick sucker punch to the stomach, which will ultimately achieve the same desired outcome, which is the capitulation of the West to the East? Will the U.S. be forced to serve the East? You all have to judge for yourselves. And remember that according to the prophecy, the capitulation from the West to the East happens shortly before the Antichrist appears on the world stage. And that's according to the prophecy of Saint Robert Bellarmine. And his last name is Bellarmine. Judge for yourselves. What do you think? Is this plausible? Remember the original rap name generator result that started this whole episode? Devil Bold. Yeah, indeed.
Yeah.
Director Awesome, if you would just want to finish up with the final thought.
Yeah. What the conclusion is, that's up to you. Believe it or not, decide for yourselves. Use your own informed judgment. Question what you're being fed through the media channels. Research for yourselves. Look at the facts. One thing is for sure. We are definitely living in interesting times. Strange days for sure. And we are seeing that the facts as they are right in front of our faces, that the power is shifting to China. And this has come about in part because of the virus that started in China and its grievous effects on the world's economies, democracies, and populations.
All right. So thanks for joining us. That's it for another episode of Pod Jerky.
Now we're gonna get down.